Hi, welcome to Sherry Tries That. I'm Sherry, this is Sadie, and welcome back, or welcome if you're new. If you are new, introduce yourself down below. We'd all love to get to know you. Today we're going to try a quick and easy Christmas craft. It doesn't take too much in the way of materials, although some of them are a little bit more unusual, so some pre-planning would be needed. Let's go ahead and get started right away. Okay, let's get started. I've got three bottles here. I of course wish that one of these was taller than the other, and I wish that this one was the same shape as these, but that's me because I'm a symmetry person. There will be people that will like better that this one is a different shape, and all three could be different shapes, and they would think that that was more interesting. So it's whatever you prefer or whatever you happen to have or can get a hold of, which is my case. These are the three that I happen to have. So I'm gonna go ahead and use them. And just like in my last Christmas craft, I will make this one a little taller by standing it on something so that I do have the three levels that I prefer. Okay. Again, this was to use some spray adhesive, and I think that I still can't get it out of here. I don't know what the problem is. I'm sure it's user error of some type, but I just can't get it to come out. So I am going to try using the Mod Podge again. And before I put the Mod Podge on the bottle, I am going to roll out my Epsom salts so that they're readily available and this doesn't get too dry, because I'm gonna put Mod Podge on the bottle, roll it in the Epsom salts and hope that they stick. I also have decided that I want to put a little bit of glitter in my Epsom salts because I'm a glitter person, and I think it would look pretty for Christmas or even just the winter. I bought the materials, aside from the bottles, for today's video from Dollarama. Buying Epsom salts at Dollarama is not economical, so I don't advise it. I did it because I was buying it at Christmas time and was not prepared to go to a whole bunch of different stores, and I paid for it. I would suggest going to a place like Walmart and getting a big bag of Epsom salts or even a jug if you think you would like to try this craft. Epsom salts are also excellent in a warm or hot bath, especially if you have aches or pains or you've been exercising. It draws the toxins out of your body and can really make you feel a lot better. Also, morbid thought, but if you've been in a car accident or something like that, it's very good to soak in an Epsom salt bath for a while. So now I'm going to, I bought a package of glitter bottles at Dollarama, and I've taken out the two white ones. They are not the same consistency as each other. They're a little bit different. So I'm just gonna kind of sprinkle them in and mix it around a bit and see what kind of effect that gives us. Oh, I can see the sparkle from here. This one has a bigger texture. I'm not sure what it is. Oh, they're more like tiny, tiny little bugle beads. They're small, but they're rectangular, not round or tiny little squares like glitter is. So they do give it a different look. And I'm gonna stir this up a bit. I think that'll be kind of a cool look. actually, if it works. All right, Mod Podge time. Oh, I'm gonna have to be careful. I see green glitter in my Mod Podge from the last craft. I don't really want a spot or two of green glitter showing through. I'd like these to be pretty pristinely white. I think I'm going to do sort of half the bottle, roll it around in the Epsom salt mixture, and then try to do the other half. Ooh. Not really giving me the coverage I want because some of the green bottle is showing through. Maybe I should paint the bottles white first. Or maybe I'll just get better coverage if I do it by hand. Yeah, I'm not going to be happy with that. So I'm going to try painting the bottles white. I'll do that and come back. Okay, we're back. As you may be able to tell, I did not paint the bottles white. I'm not sure why, but I just didn't want to do it. I think that it was going to take several coats and they would have to dry in between, and I really wanted to go a little bit faster than that. I had some silver spray paint, so I use that. They're not perfectly painted by any means, plus it was slightly raining outside when I did it, but that doesn't matter. They're going to be covered, and it's with a textured thing, so you know, if there are some drips or bumps or what have you, it doesn't really matter. We're gonna go from here and try it. Now the only thing is, here I didn't really spray paint this side. Bless you. And you can still, I think you can still see the green through it. So I may just leave that for now and put that side to the back. Cheating, but this is what happens when you try things. Hi, Soph. Hi. Mommy's working on something, so I can't pet you. But you can lie down near me, even on my feet if you want to. Yeah. We'll snuggle tonight. We'll watch a movie. Okay, we are going to put Mod Podge on these now and see how this works. Okay, that looks all right. I had pictured them more densely covered, but I think I'm gonna do a first coat on everything, and then I'll go back and see if I can get more on it. Okay, not great. One of the things I found is that trying to put some more Mod Podge on the bottle beside where I already had the Epsom salts was difficult. So on the next bottle, I'm gonna try Mod Podging the whole thing at once and then rolling it around. We'll see if that works any better. All right, so something that I just realized is that when I'm doing the neck of the bottle, I was putting the whole bottle down, and what was happening is that I was wiping some of the Mod Podge off by rolling it down on the paper where there's no Epsom salts. So I will have to sort of watch doing that. So as not to take the Mod Podge off of the bottle. That's better. Not perfect. Maybe not even stunningly great, but I think it's better than the first one. Maybe not. There's definitely bald spots. I don't know if I missed putting Mod Podge in these spots or what exactly. And it's hard to get Mod Podge on there. Once you've got it on the surrounding areas, you end up taking off more Epsom salts than anything. Yeah. All right, I'm not thrilled with this. But I will do the last bottle and then go back and see what we can salvage or fix. I don't know if this is making a difference or not. It may be. is that these Epsom salts are, I think, sort of bigger, thicker than the Epsom salts that I remember having before. The Epsom salts that I remember having before were fairly fine, like salt. These are thicker, they're bigger, they're chunkier. And I think I would get better coverage if I had a finer ground Epsom salt. I think this might also work better if I actually had spray adhesive instead of Mod Podge, but I don't know that for sure. This really isn't turning out as I had hoped. Oh, it looks like little flakes of the silver paint are now coming off. Well, this seems to be the best one so far, but I also think it would have been better if I had painted them white as opposed to silver. Although, what I have to go in them are some glittery silver sprigs, so they might, the silver might seem better once those are in them as well. I think I'm gonna call it. I don't think continuing to do what I'm doing is going to make it any better. We still learned something about how to do this and how not to do this. So perhaps this is a fail. That's it. So what did you think? I personally think it was a fail, and I won't be offended if you think so too. If you think it was a fail, don't give the video a thumbs down. Just let me know in the comments that you think it was a fail. And if you've tried something similar, what worked for you? What suggestions do you have for me for next time? I do think I'm going to try this one again. I'll have to drink 3 bottles of wine first, but once I have the bottles collected, I want to try a different brand of Epsom salts. I really think that if they are a smaller texture, it might work better. And I might try a spray adhesive again, although I'm not having much luck with that, but I'll try. Thank you again so much for watching my video. I really do appreciate it. Would love to have you subscribe. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you're notified when my next video is posted. Sophie, Sadie, and I would like to take this opportunity to say Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to everyone watching. I hope you have a safe and happy holiday. We'll see you in the next video. Bye!